In this video, we'll walk through the installation of the PI Integrator for Esri ArcGIS Configuration Portal. The Configuration Portal is the web server component of the PI Integrator for Esri ArcGIS, and it's used to define map services and layers which expose the PI assets and data to the Esri platform. It also functions as the data server. This component needs to get installed first. Also, if you're unfamiliar with the architecture pieces that are used to connect to the Esri platform and the data flow, you can watch our architecture full details video, which will familiarize you with the terms that I'm going to be using in the installation and later configuration. Before beginning the installation, the first thing I want to do is confirm that this machine that I'm going to be installing the configuration portal to has the right operating system. So I can see that the operating system is Windows Server 2012 R2, and that works because Windows Server 2012 and higher is supported. I also have installed the required server roles and role services. These requirements can be found in the user guide, specifically right here in this section. I have already installed these server roles and role services using Server Manager and then the Add Roles and Features wizard. Again, this is something that I have already done on this machine. Those are good. And the next thing I'm going to do is look under IIS Manager. And because IIS was just installed here under IIS Manager, you can see that I only have the default website. And I just want to let you know that I'm going to be installing the configuration portal to the default website. Last thing I need to check is the SQL access permissions. The configuration portal has a database, and that database has to be hosted in a SQL server. And it has to be hosted in a SQL server that's 2008 R2 or later. So I have the SQL server, and I'm going to actually take a look in SQL Server Management Studio. I'm going to be running the installation under my cMetzinger user account, and this account, in order to do the recommended Windows authentication to connect to SQL, will need DB Creator and Security Admin. And this is just permissions that are needed during the installation. You can see that I have additional permissions, but that is not required. And the installer will actually create a login that's specific for the configuration portal that will have the right permissions to the portal database. So these two selected permissions are not needed after the installation has finished. Let's get started with the installation. I have downloaded the install kit from the OSIsoft tech support website. And the account that I'm logged in is cMetzinger, which we can see right there. And cMetzinger is part of the local administrators group on this machine, and I'm going to be running the installation as the administrator. You can hit OK if you want to extract the setup files to this default path. I actually want to go ahead and extract the files to a specific location, but that's of course up to your preference. And we'll begin the installation. The first thing that it's going to ask is for the destination folder. You can go ahead and choose the default. If you do happen to have more than one drive on your machine and you are separating your applications from your operating system on different drives, you can go ahead and change drives right here. And then you need to select the IIS website where the web application will be installed. We saw earlier that I only have the default website, and this is the selection that I'm going to make here. Next, I'll need to fill out information regarding the SQL server. I'm going to leave the database name as PI Geo Portal, and I'm going to use the Windows integrated authentication to connect to MySQL server. So that's been validated, and then I'll go ahead and hit next and install. And you can see that it has finished, so I'll go ahead and hit finish. I chose not to launch the configuration portal because there's actually a couple things in IIS Manager that I want to take a look at now. You can see that PI Geo Portal under the default website. I do want to confirm a couple things under authentication right here. I need to make sure that anonymous authentication and Windows authentication are enabled. And I also need to take a look at the bindings for the website. So I'll go to Edit Bindings. Now the default website is using the standard ports for the HTTP and HTTPS binding. It is important that the ports for the website that the configuration portal is installed to are open on this machine. I have already taken care of that. And additionally, I'm going to now go through the steps to enable secure HTTPS access to the portal. And both HTTP and HTTPS are absolutely required, and the site won't function without both of them being present. So here, I'm going to keep it at the default port 443, and for the host name, I'm going to use the fully qualified domain name. And I also need to make sure that I have a certificate selected in the SSL certificate field. SSL validates websites using certificates, and when Windows is installed, basically a machine certificate should be created automatically. And depending on your particular IT policies, you can use the existing machine certificate, which is what I'm doing, or your IT group may issue a certificate that's specifically for your internal portal website. So if you have a custom certificate, you could select that. I am going to be selecting the machine certificate that's there. I'll close this, and then I'm going to browse to the configuration portal using this option over here on the right. And depending on the operating system, if when trying to navigate to the portal in Internet Explorer, you see this type of message, this page can't be displayed, you may just need to add the configuration portal to the trusted websites. I'm going to go ahead and do that through Internet Options. So I'm going to go ahead and add this to my trusted websites. I'm going to close Internet Explorer, and let me browse again. And I just got prompted for some credentials, and I'm going to enter the credentials of the installing user. Now you can see I was able to successfully open the configuration portal, and the URL for the configuration portal you can see is the fully qualified domain name, and then it has this PI Geo portal, and then from there, we're looking under configuration and services, but this is needed for the URL. You'll also notice that I'm logged in as the particular user that I entered the credentials for, and the reason why I can log into the configuration portal is because during the installation, there are specific local Windows groups that gets created, and the installing user was added to those groups. I can take a look at those groups. I'm going to look through and go from Server Manager to Tools and Computer Management. And under Local Users and Groups, the two groups that got created during the installation are the PyGeo admins and the PyGeo users. And the installer user got added to PyGeo admins, which is why I can log in successfully to the portal. So this is the mechanism to add new users and administrators to the configuration portal. You add them to these Windows groups. Looking back at the portal, there's something that immediately is drawing my attention. It says that there are these errors. So let me navigate to that. And the error message is letting me know that the data relay client is unavailable. And that's because I haven't gone ahead and installed the data relay yet, which is the next step that we're going to take a look at. To install the data relay, the files can be downloaded under Administration and Data Relay. And you can see the same warning that I do not have a data relay installed, properly configured, or running. And one thing to point out about the PyGeo admin and PyGeo users Windows groups is the difference between PyGeo admins and PyGeo users is that PyGeo admins will have the data relay tab available in the configuration portal because they're able to install the data relay. So we have the configuration portal successfully installed, and in the next video, we'll walk through the installation of the data relay.